Hey guys, I'm Brett Berry, and today on Math Hacks, I am showing you a super handy little trick that will not only boost your number skills, but will also keep you from reaching for that calculator. In today's tutorial, we are talking all about factor trees. Now, factor trees are pretty cool because they help us take large numbers and break them down into their prime components. Now, once we have these prime components, we can do all sorts of really interesting things, including we can quickly and easily find the greatest common factor, least common multiple, we can reduce fractions, we can even simplify radicals. Trust me, you're gonna really love this trick. So to start off, I'm gonna show you how to make a factor tree for two numbers. We're gonna make a factor tree for the number 45 and for the number 120. So all a factor tree is breaking down your number into its prime components. And you can think of the prime components as the building blocks of every number. So for 45, I want to start my tree by drawing two branches. And here I'm just going to write two numbers that multiply to 45, and they can be any numbers that come to mind. So for me, the first numbers that multiply to 45 that I can think of are 9 times 5. Now, once I get a prime number, that's the end of that branch. So I'm just going to circle it. And then I'm going to go to whatever numbers are remaining, whatever branches I have, and put two more branches and repeat this process. So now I want to think of any numbers that multiply to 9. So here I think about 3 times 3. And those are both prime numbers, so I'm going to circle them. Once all my branches are complete, I have found the prime factorization. So the only numbers I don't want to write is just 1 times itself, because that's just not really going to help my tree. I'm just going to have the same number I have to keep working down with. Here, the prime factorization of 45 then is 3 times 3 times 5. Or if I want to use exponents, that's 3 squared times 5. Let's try another one. So here I'm going to do my two branches off of 120. And the first numbers that I can think of are 10 times 12. Now both of those are composite numbers. So two more branches on each. 5 times 2 equals 10. And 6 times 2 equals 12. The 5 and the 2s are primes, so those branches are done. And the last two numbers I need to write here to get 6 is 3 times 2, and those are primes, so that's done. This is now my complete factor tree, and I can write the prime factorization. So I'm just going to see what numbers I have. I have 3 2s. So that's going to be 2 cubed, a 3 times 3, and a 5, so times 5. Now the cool thing about these prime factorizations is they're the prime numbers that if I multiply them all together, I get the number I started with. So it is kind of like the unique signature of 120 is 2 cubed times 3 times 5. Those are its building blocks. So now I'm going to show you some cool things that you can do once you find your factor trees. Let's find the GCF, or the greatest common factor, of 45 and 120. So what you need to do is you need to multiply the factors that are common to both. So as you can tell, I have a 3 and 5 that are common to both of my factorizations. So I'm going to take only what is common to both. So I have a 3, looks like this is to the first power, so just 3, and I have 1 5. So when I multiply these together, I get 15, and 15 is the GCF of 45 and 120. Now let's find the least common multiple of 45 and 120. So we're looking for the smallest number that both 45 and 120 go into now. Again, you could do this longhand by listing out multiples of 45 and multiples of 120 and looking for the one that the smallest one that occurs on both lists. But this is all about finding those shortcuts using the prime factorizations. So to do that, what we're going to do here is take the largest multiple from each of these prime factorizations and multiply it all together. So looking at this, I have 2s, 3s, and 5s between these two factorizations. Now I'm going to choose the largest power that shows up on each of these. So for the 2, the largest power is 3. For the 3, the largest power is 2. And for the 5, it looks like we just have 5 on both of it, so the largest power is 1. Now all that's left to do is multiply these values all together. There you go. 360 is our least common multiple of 45 and 120. Another thing you can do with these prime factorizations is you can use it as a handy tool for reducing. So say we had a fraction of 45 over 120. We could sub in the corresponding prime factorizations and then go ahead and just cross cancel. So looking here, I have a 5 on top and 5 on bottom, so those cancel out. And I have 2 3s on top and 1 3 in bottom, so I can get rid of one of these 3s with 1 on top, leaving behind 1 3 in the numerator. Now all that's left to do is go ahead and multiply these out. So I have 3 to the first power, which is 3, and 2 to the third power, which is 8. So I quickly and easily was able to reduce 45 over 120 with just a couple little cancellations. Isn't that cool? I love that. All right, so another thing that we can do with prime factorizations is we can use it to help us simplify square roots. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm just gonna go ahead and replace 45 with its prime factorization of 3 squared times 5. And then using the rules of radicals, I can split this into 2 separate radicals. All right, and then it's really easy to see that the square root of 3 squared, simply 3. You can kind of think of it as the square root cancels out with a square power. So we get 3 square root 5. Just like square roots, we can also reduce cube roots or higher order indexed roots. I'm going to do the exact same process here. And then I'm going to split this into separate roots. That allows me to cancel out the cube root with the cube on the 2. So I simply get 2 here. And these radicals I can't reduce, so I'm just going to put them back together into one radical because there's no sense in having 2 separate ones. So that's just going to be the cube root of 3 times 5, which is 15. There you go. So what do you think? Do you think factor trees will help simplify your math? Let me know in the comments below. And don't forget, I have a free printable for you to download linked in the description box below. It has notes about today's lesson along with some practice problems. And as always, I really appreciate it when you give me a big thumbs up and subscribe to the channel so that you can get more math hacks in your feed. Till next time, I'm Brett Berry, and thanks for watching.